Hello there! In this video, I will be showing you how to set up your own custom voice warning system using the War Thunder Real-Time Information Program. For context, a voice warning system is an audio cue that tells the pilot if they had reached a certain limit to the aircraft's performance in order to avoid catastrophic failures. This system can be found in various forms, such as the US Navy's Betty,
pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up, flight controls. Flight controls.
Or the Russian VVS readup.
Предельный угол атаки. Предельная перегрузка.
To start, you will need to download the program from GitHub and launch it before you launch the game itself. Keep in mind that you can only use the on-screen display with windowed or windowed borderless mode. It is possible to run the program in full screen mode, but you will need to download the Riva Tuner Statistics Server and change the OSD type to RTSS in the WTRTI settings. The link to both of these programs will be available in the description below. However, before we can start setting up our custom voice warning system, we need to add certain indicators to the main menu. You can do this by pressing the Add button. Select your desired indicator and press OK. You can play around with all of the available indicators on your own time, but for me personally, the most essential indicators is to have are fuel percentage, mass of fuel, wing flutter, gear flutter, flaps flutter, turn rate, load factor, and critical AOA. These indicators will appear by default on your screen as you play the game. You can untick the show OSD box if you want to play without the indicators. Don't worry, the program will select the flight model data automatically. You can check the exact limit to your aircraft superstructure by pressing Alt and W. If the parameters are indicating zero on all sectors, then the aircraft might be a new addition to the game and as such haven't received their flight model data yet. Open the program regularly and check for automatic FM updates. You can customize the location of the indicators by going into the Settings tab, then focusing your attention on the layout parameters. The Position tab dictates where the indicators appear on your screen. The left number input controls the position on the X axis, that is the horizontal axis, and the right number input controls the position of the Y axis, or the vertical axis. Scale controls the font size of the indicators. Indicators in a row control whether or not an indicator can appear on the same line that the previous indicator appears upon. This is useful for creating columns. Indicator interval controls the spacing between indicators in a row. And finally, value alignment controls the vertical spacing between an indicator and the one below it. You can also make multiple groups of indicators and position them individually by pressing the triple dot button next to the group parameter. Input the name of the desired group, and then pressing the Add button. Put your indicators to the individual groups by clicking and dragging the indicators to the desired groups. You can also change the color of the indicators, their values, and their units by going to the color scheme parameters. By default, the color scheme controls all the indicators' colors, and you can change it by selecting one of the pre-made presets, or by adding your own custom color from the color editor. You can also edit each individual indicator's color by going to the Settings tab one by one, but personally, I wouldn't recommend doing this. But if you, by any chance, want to have a rainbow display, then be my guest. And now we can finally set up our own custom voice warning system. To do this, start by going back to the main menu and double-clicking your desired indicator. I'll be using the flaps flutter indicator for this demonstration. You will want to focus your attention on the alert parameters, press the Add button, and a new input on the value table should appear. Double-click on that. Now, the way the flaps flutter indicator works is that it calculates the maximum speed at which your aircraft's flaps can deploy. and then converts it to a 100th percentage. In this case, I want the voice warning system to notify me that I have reached beyond the maximum deployable speed and not before it. For that, I'd want to change the if value symbol to the greater than symbol, and then input 100 next to it. And if for some reason you want the program to notify you of a range of speeds for, let's say, 50 to 70% flutter, then you'd want to change the symbols to equals 2, taking the range box and then inputting 50 and 70 on the boxes like so. Here, the voice will activate when your flaps are deployed between 50 and 70% of its maximum deploy speed. Why would you want this? I don't know. Next, you can also make the indicator color flash or blink in a steady color. By default, it should be set to red. You can make it flash the colors by inputting an interval range. Keep in mind that this number is multiplied by the indicator update refresh rate. I've had mine set at 0 milliseconds, and as such, this interval number is multiplied by 100 milliseconds. You can also control which values flash or blink by ticking or unticking the boxes below it. And now, the play sound parameter. You can select from the pre-made sound effects, or you can add in your own custom sounds. And for what sounds you should add, well, I'd say you'd have to make your own. Or you can simply download my own pre-made profile sounds package that you can download from the link in the description below. Remember, WTRTI is highly customizable, and you should play around with it yourself and see what works best for your needs.
Предельный угол атаки.
That's all for me today. Please consider giving this video a like and subscribe to my channel, and thank you very much for watching this video.